Okay, so we are back. Now let's fire up our door and we create a new session. Let's music sessions. Let's the folders around it. Let's create it inside here so that we have all in one place. And the session name is folders around it. I don't use a template because we want to do it from scratch. So, no risk, no fun. Also, let now our doer start up. And we get an empty outer session. So, and also no risk, no fun. So I've this outer is 4.6.170. So you should be able also to use only version 4.6, the stable, current stable version, at this moment in time. But I always pull from Git, and this is always a risk. Sometimes things don't work anymore afterwards, but no risk, no fun. So, just recommend not to update if you're in the middle of an audio production. You can get all sorts of weird stuff going. So, empty outer session. So, first thing is we import the MIDI. So, session import. We go to the folder surrounded Muse, and here we have the surrounded MIDI. We import it to this session start, and we let the reasonable synth be the instrument, just to be able to quickly hear it. So it's only a very reasonable sound, not quite pleasant, but it's okay. So, and close. So honey, here we have now the MIDI notes. So this first track is the system track. And remove it. Then we have here the two drum tracks. If so, not so easy to see. So the first thing is, it's always good is note range fit contents. Note range fit contents, and then we switch the drum tracks to percussive mode. No. So, this drum track is the drum gizmo drum track. It's the last one. Yep. So, this one we can remove. This is the not edited one. So, remove this track. Yes, remove it. Then save. So then just name the tracks. So, piano MIDI. So, save them with Control S, always save. It's always better to save one more time than have them gruesome faces. So, okay, we have the tracks now. Then we will have adjust this a bit so we don't need the time code, don't need the bars and samples, meter, tempo, ranges, and don't need the CD markers. So, and if we don't hear anything because, as usual, the master is not connected to my sound card. Maybe you could hear it on the screen reader because the screen recorder should have recorded it, but I don't hear it in the headphones. The monitor out also. Yeah, the simple screen recorder was connected. So you did probably hear it, I don't. So now I should. So surrounded on speed. The thing is, Arda unfortunately doesn't import the tempo, meter and tempo changes. So we have to do that manually, which is quite a bit of a. Yeah, it's not that nice, but anyway. So we go into Muse, and we have to do this manually. So we go in Muse, we go edit master track list. Here we have the list of the tempo and keys change, meter and tempo changes. So say always on top. And if we change back to our door, we have it here. So go to the beginning, and we start with tempo 65.99, which is to be exact 66. and time signature full 4. That's okay. The next thing is 17. Track 17. I change here this to bars, so that the grid is on bars, so that we have we click on the bar ranges easier. We have to change the meter to 6/4. The meter is up here, so we right click new meter, 6/4, and then on 18 it changes back to 4/4. 17, this is 18, 4/4. You see it's a little bit longer here. Then on 26 we change to 84. 26 we change the tempo, the new tempo, which is on the next line, to 84. And on 28 we change the meter 9/8 and the tempo to 82. 9/8 and 82, yeah. And then on 44 we go back to 4/4. Yep. And on 55 we go back to 9/8. 54, sorry. 54 we go back to 9/8. 62 to 4/4. 62 4/4. Yep. And now we have this. Now it has truncated the metadata. Don't know why. So okay, if you set the tempo, okay, so then it's definitely not a bug and not a feature in Arduino. So because of the tempo changes, and it enlarges and closes them in because of tempo and meter changes, so it cuts here off. The metadata is still there, but it cuts off. So we would now have to go to 89, and it's not there. So this is definitely a bug in Arduino. So if we pull that out, let's make it like that. Yeah, and here starts the media again. So, Yep, don't have here something, so we close this back. We have full MIDI here, have MIDI here, but it stops here. This is the lead, I think. Yeah, we have the lead here, but just here, and of course the drums go to here, so we give the symbols a little time to ring out. Save this stuff. So next thing, we have the still some tempo changes to go. So on 89, okay, we're still on tempo 82, but this is then 90. You see here a ramp, so it ramps down the speed, and you can't do that with Arduino. So we'll do a workaround and just gradually put it down, so I get to 89, which is still 82, and then 90 it starts to change to slow down. So we will just insert a tempo change here. We go down to say something like 76, and then for 91 we go down to 60. So And let's see. Beats. Let's see if that's okay. Did something go wrong here? If there is a problem somewhere. Let's have a look. Okay, start here. So we have to change the 640, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's okay. Then we have 26, we go quicker. So this sounds like this. And as you hear, the drums sound quite horrible with the reasonable sense, so we mute them. So this is 9/8, then we go to 45 to 44. Let's see if that was right. No, it's 44. Okay. Then we go 54. We go to 9/8. Yeah. And then 62 to 44. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah. So 89, we have to slow down. 91, yeah, and now it fits. Yeah, that's okay. So let's see if this first tempo is okay. Let go a little bit lower, like 55, and here with 70. That's okay. So, and then we go back with whoop. That's the ramp, and then we should go back to normal tempo with 92. Yeah, it's 66 again, like in the beginning. So new tempo 66. And this goes to the end. Then we have another ramp here, which starts from 102. 103, so we'll just go here to also to 55. Soup, yeah, that's something that Ardo doesn't have, but that should it be. So that's a bug. Yep. Yeah, this sentence here. So and we will do. Yep. So it should be okay. Of course, save it. Control S, always save as much as you can. So the next thing is a little bit cutting the MIDI. So we did it for the end. The end should be okay, but now we have the beginning. So let's go to the beginning and just select all. And first thing is to get it a little down. I like to let it a bit in the beginning. So. And also fit contents is always a good idea. I think it's mostly the standard for default mode, so but okay, yeah, here we start with the bass starts nearly immediately. The mellow pad starts here. This is the lead and the drums. Oh, this was too much. Drums start here. Lead here. And the thing is, I've enabled the smart mode, so you have the grab mode and the range mode in one go. So if you are in the lower range of a region, you see this is the grab mode, and if you go in the upper part, you have the range mode. So this is quite interesting. So I can select the range here in the upper part, and then with delete or Control X, remove it. And we'll do this for some stuff. So it's 2 bars. Let's let this. I let 1 bar for the ring out later for the printing of the tracks. Yeah, it's too short, maybe. Depends also on the instrument. Nothing to cut for the bass. Then here is the electric piano. Got it. Strings. And you can also this range edit after you have selected it, which is really a nice feature. Yep, and then we have only the piano. So let's do it a little bit coarse now. So, and then zoom in. Do the fine work. Good. Save it. Should be fine. So let's get rid of this horrible sound. Next thing. Don't forget to save. So first thing is we start with the drums. The next what I like to do also is to make more space, make this small. So I can do this via right clicking, selecting the tracks, right clicking, height small. You can do it via the track. Not here. Oh yeah, here height. And I have selected some shortcuts, so F to the fit selection and small to control one. So then I can, so for example, if I want to the bass and the mellow pad, and then I press F, the shortcut, and then I get to focus on this. Oh, what happened here? Oh yeah, that's another bug. These are ghost notes. Sometimes they appear and Ardour draws them. They appear then. They disappear, I mean. But sometimes they are there, yeah. These are ghost notes. It got better with the latest fixes, but it's not gone completely. So okay, so let's start with the drums. So let's first remove this shitty reasonable sense. I mean, it's not a shit instrument, it's only the sound that's not really that's nice. So let's right click new plugin, plugin manager, and we get our much more mightier drum gizmo and insert Zip. And then we load again the module kit and the minimap. Set this at 4 and 6. Doesn't matter, you can switch it off if you like. And then the important thing is also, so yeah, Arduino thinks this is a 16 channel surround sound, which is not the case. So we go here, right click, bypass, and then we have it goes straight to the master, and now we should have drums. Good. So next thing is, we want to be able to control the volume and also to have tracks to later print them. So that's the first thing I will do. And we have 2 stereo tracks and the rest, and 11, I think 11 mono tracks. So let's just track, add track or bus. So we add 2 audio tracks and just a placeholder for the name in stereo. Last, and then we add 11 audio tracks mono. Control 1 to make them small. Yeah, so done. We to have the mapping, we go up. Have I closed it now? Yeah. I go to my readme file from Drumgizmo Sounds, Drum Kits, Modjot Kits, and there's the readme. Yep, stick it on top, always on top. And then, so we have a stereo, and then we have 1, 2, 3 mono, and then we have the stereo again. So this second stereo, I move it down with control up and down arrows. And then we have the mapping. So let's choose an ambience. Then we have the hi-hat, left, kick right. These are the overheads. Right, left, right, right. Snare bottom, snare top. Tom 1, Tom 2, Tom 3, and the floor tom. Don't use the trigger. Yep, that's pretty much it. We create the group, and I don't give it a name usually, so the group is now enabled. Now we don't need this stuff anymore, so let's let it in the background. So now we need to connect this stuff. First, yeah, that's very important. Table the group. The thing is, if you want to connect something, then Arduino, I don't know if it's a bug or a feature, but I found that if you print tracks, a root tracks, an audio track to another audio track, and then print it, and even if you see here it's not connected, yeah, you should go here, left click, and say disconnect. If you don't do it, and you print it, then so the audio track will get shifted for some amount, yeah, and this sounds really strange. And I spent hours on searching the cause for this, so I quickly do this, the old disconnect. I don't know why this happens, so it's wise to do. Goody, goody, goody. So, so now we do the routing. So we go window audio connections, and then we have the other tracks. And so we have here the 16 channels of Drumgizmo. And first, we go to buses and we see that they go all to the master bus and we want to go then to the tracks, so we remove them from here. And then we go to tracks, and now we want to connect them to this tracks we just created. And if we have created them in the right order, then it's just a matter of going diagonally down. Yep. Okay, that's the first thing. And now we should be able to have a sound. We don't hear the drums, yeah. The thing is, we have to go here, have the group enabled, and click on the in button. And now we should hear the drums. And now we have individual channels for the drums, which is necessary for mixing them. And it's also nice that the in button is now changed via the group settings. This was not the case in previous audio versions, and I really liked it. So. And one thing again, we add another, this time a bus, and we just need one. And this is the drums master, and it is stereo last. So we add it. And then we route it again, so audio connections. And we go to outdoor tracks, and now to buses. And now our drum tracks go all to the master. And I want to have a final fader for the drums alone, so we remove them from the master. Yep, and then put them on the drums master. The drum master goes then to the final master, to the real master, to the master of masters. Beep. So save it. And, yeah, we have all here. And we can only from the drum kit. Yeah, something that's maybe it's also a nice feature. If you control and click onto a fader, then it goes to zero, and if you shift and click, then it goes to 0 dB, to normal volume. It's quite nice sometimes. So we have a little bit of too much gain here. That's because we have not changed the volume of the tracks. Anyway, first thing is I want to print them down to audio, so that we can then disable this drum gizmo and the track. So drum gizmo can use quite a lot of RAM, and to save that, also we have another instance running here in the Muse and so on. I think we can then close the Muse. We will do that later. And let's have a look first. It should be okay. So that the final. So that the ring out of the cymbals should be, yeah. So we give it the 93, so we close the 293. Then the cymbals should have time to ring out. So let's zoom out a bit. Oops. So let's print these tracks for the drums. So we have routed them here, so it's a matter of simple. We select the drums, select the punch range, and you can do this via transport set punch from selection. And I put this on the parentheses, the loop and the punch range on the num keypad. So I can do it with a shortcut and don't have to go every time here. The punch range is set to the drums. Click record. The tracks are now armed. Click here. And then we click play section range. And this will get then the drum tracks printed. So I will then cut this out of the video because it's a boring process. But to show you at least the beginning. So. Okay, so finished. During recording, I also found another error in the toms here. So I just corrected that and did it in another print. So, but the print is now finished and it's okay. So one thing I forgot completely is, so now we disable the recording. I disable the group, and for example, you see the kick left, it's not used anywhere. So I should have removed it before, but forgot. So we remove it now. Yes, remove it. And also we have the right, the left right and the right right. This is the close mics. And this is just the garbage in the mixing, but the left right is used, but not the right right. So remove that also, if we don't need it. So, and now we turn on the group again and switch the in part. And now we can mute drum gizmo, also disable it here. And if we play, now we have the audio tracks. And what I like to do is, because if it's muted, you see it's still processing here. And if drum gizmo would run, it would do still things. So what you can do in Arduino is right click on the track and say, deactivate this track, so then it's not processed, yeah, and doesn't eat up any resources. So I do this for all MIDI tracks if we don't need them anymore. So first thing, yeah. Next thing is, let's set up a little bit of volume. Now the drum kit is all full up, even volume, which we don't like. So save control S, yeah, as always. So we get here the mixer of Arduino, and so first thing is we go to the right and we solo the drum master, so that we have all drums with the group, disable the group, and then click everything to zero with control and then clicking on the slider. Yep, so, and then we start to play, and then bring in first the kick, and the best thing is around minus 15. Then bring back, okay, yeah, I forgot something other, so let's let the mixer. The other thing is, this is not really the direction, the sequence of tracks I like, so, I will change this now that we've recorded it, and so we have kick and snare first, then comes the hi-hat, then the toms, the ambience is the last, then the ride and the overheads, right, and move this up, something like that. I like that more. This is just my workflow, how I do it. So the microphone got a bit moving. Okay, so let's go back to the mixer. Yes, now that's better. So if you play, we have the kick here. It should be by minus 15 so that we have enough headroom. This is the bottom. Let's start with the top first. So this is about the mixture I would use. So let's then the overhead are quite important. Yeah, you hear the hi-hat is also going through the overheads, of course. And also you hear that one of the weaknesses of the Muljot kit, in my opinion, is the sound of the toms. So in mixing, they require some heavy processing, at least in my opinion. Kick and snare is not also the best. Ah, yeah, I forgot. If we have the readme still open, yeah. Yeah, and here is, there are phasing issues between the snare top, and so remember to phase reverse one of them. So if we play, and we just flip the phase of one of them, this snare has more. So this is without. This is with. So the snare has more, a little bit more punch. Yeah, that's because there's a phasing issue between the top and the bottom microphone. And normally, I reverse the bottom microphone. So. It's but isn't it's all about the mixture about the top and the bottom microphone, so it's something like that. The toms are quite here, so this is just a brief thing, and then we have to also add the ambience, but I want to go from the beginning because the ride is only on the beginning. Yep. And it comes also through the overheads, of course. And this is the room microphones. Toms are a bit too loud. It's okay for the beginning. This should be okay. Okay, drums. So, next thing. We'll start with the piano. So, if we listen to it with the reasonable. Yeah. Okay, so we remove it quite quickly, and we want to use the Linux sampler for this. Yeah. So I'll just start it. Audio production sound generators, and the front ends for the Linux sampler. One is QSampler and one is Fantasia. And QSampler for some reason crashes on my machine, so I use Fantasia. That's it. So the first thing, we need the input, so we need to check input MIDI device, and we also need the output device. Check, it's a stereo, it's called Linux sampler, create, and then we want to have the this. So this is the input MIDI channel, MIDI in 0, this MIDI port channel 1. Yeah, that's another thing. It plays back all. So I tend to use this. So use a single fixed channel for all playback, and this is channel 1. So it's saves you for some problems. Then the strings were channel 2, if I remember. I've closed Muse already, so I will have them to look it up. Anyway, for now we use the piano, Fantasia, and we load an instrument, and you can load instrument files, and on the Linux sampler page itself, there is a fantastic piano, and it's the Maestro Grand Concert. You can download it directly from the Linux sampler homepage, and it's completely free and it's good. It's about 1 gigabyte, I think. Yep. Okay, so it has loaded it. We don't hear it because we don't have connected anything. So we'll do just that. Another thing, we add another audio track for the piano. One, it's called piano. It's a stereo track and it's an audio track, very important. And after selection. Yep. Then we do here the same. Yeah, the same as I told you, left click, say disconnect. And then we click right and we get the routing. And with, from the tracks, we go to the piano out and connect it to our piano. The piano MIDI out connected to the piano. Sorry. No, that's not right. We want the other and we connect the Linux sampler, the output of Linux sampler to the piano. And we also need to connect the MIDI connection, so we connect the audio tracks. No, there. So the tracks, the piano, we connected to the Linux sampler. Then we switch again the piano to in, so that we hear what's on the input. And if we have done it correctly, we should now hear nothing. We get the input signal, and piano out goes to master. Ah, okay. Yeah, should be okay. Ah, we have the solo. That's the problem. And this already sounds much, much better. So we solo both tracks. That's at least as a piano should, as a minimum requirement sound. So, Linux sampler is quite good, and also from the velocities here, from the velocities, it reacts better than Twit and the Carl Fluid Synth we used in Muse. So, let's zoom in. Yeah, and I should say that this is from Surrounded. This is not really directly the album version. It's more the version from the Live at the Marquee, a little bit a blend of the two, because it sets a different beginning. The beginning is normally a synthesizer and included into the piano. So, and we do the same for both of them. Select them, set the punch range. Set that record. And go. And I do this for both and will pause the video because it's boring. Okay, so I did this for both parts of the piano. So just switch this to mute, switch this recording off and switch it to in, and then we should hear it. So I had a lot better than the reasonable synth. Okay, so I'm back again. Can disable the solo and now deactivate this channel, save the file. Good. So we don't need the Fantasia anymore. So to free the memory, we quit. Next, we could do the strings, the electro piano, the let's do the bass first. Bass is always funny. So with the drums, with the piano, so let's do the bass. For the bass, yeah, the bass sounds reasonable. So delete it. And for the bass, I use a plugin, a free plugin, and it's it's called. I don't know, but it's a Windows plugin, so you can't use Windows plugins directly in Arduino. But of course, we have our good old girlfriend, Carla. So I go into Plugin Manager, and we get the Carla rack in this time, so it's not the patch bay. Difference is this is just a rack and the flow of the plugins automatically connected from top to bottom. So add plugins and I don't remember how it is called, but I think it's Samsara on Bass. I think I will put a link to the download somewhere. Add that plugin. Okay, we need another track, of course. So this track is called Bass. It's a mono track in this case. After selection. Yep. So again here, disconnect first, then right click, and I go tracks, bass out. We connect both, so I get a little bit more input. And it's a little bit low, so the thing is, let's go here. So I select this and can we directly do this here? Yeah, melee, transpose, and we put this two octaves up. Transpose. Okay, it distorts a bit. It was too much for the connection, so. Now this one, just use one. So this is a bit high output volume, so we'll look. So the plugin looks like this. There's some quite nice features, that's why I like that plugin. So you can first we have the finger setting, we turn the tone velocity, the volume down a bit. Switch different styles. So we'll use the finger because, yeah, it's the natural sound. I feel like here the velocity is okay. You can also adjust the string rattle here. And the velocity is low. Don't want this. We have a tuner here. This is just the MIDI channel and the band range. Then you can hear the add an effect, the delay, flanger, tremolo. We don't need that. You can adjust the envelope, the attack, decay, thruster, release. Then we have here EQ. This is nice because we will enable that. And then pull out the 50 Hz because this is where the bass kick drum resides. Pull a bit out the low mids. And you could also add a limiter. and the distortion if you want. I don't need it, so. It sounds quite okay. So we'll go back up again in volume. Yeah, that's okay. So just a little bit bigger. So just select it, set the punch range, and we have it here. Record, it's set on record. Ah, okay. Okay, so that's the bass. So we mute it, set it to inactive. We can remove the color rack again. And we have the bass. So let's see how it sounds with the piano and the bass together. Quite nice. So, you know, what I also like to do is to group the disabled tracks. So absolutely with the piano, the bass, and put all the drums up there. Good, save it. So next, go to the strings. Okay, for the strings, we add another track. Stereo. Disconnected to the synth, of course, we don't have yet. So for this I will use a synthesizer. Sound generator is called Yoshimi. It's a fork of Synet Sub FX. It's basically the same, just it's more suited for Jack, usage with Jack. And the thing is, I couldn't get the Synet plugins for Ardu working correctly, so I use an external synth. And so I'll do the connections now. So we connect the output of Yoshimi, the left right, to the strings in. Switch that. And connect the MIDI connections. We connect the piano strings out to Yoshimi. And delete the reason error sense, of course. The strings are, we have to set this correctly, they are on channel 2. So Yoshimi, channel 2. Yeah. What a nice sound. So stick that on top. So we go, yeah, these are the default banks of, and I just go to the strings, yeah, and then try a few, and let's see. Thank you. So I say I like that best, and the only thing is the swell in, so the attack is a little bit high. So let's see if we can do something. So if you know Yoshimi or Zenitsu-FX, you can do lots of stuff with it. If you don't and you want to know how to edit this stuff, check the YouTube channel of Paul Nasker, who wrote Zenitsu-FX, and of course Unfa, which has a lot of tutorials on it. So I'll try to just reduce the attack time a bit. That and also, so we'll just shifted it accidentally. We'll make a loop. I just want to add a little bit to that sound. So we have only a pad synth, so I want also to add an ADD synth. So just do this. Then let's loop this. And let's see what we can do here. So now let's add in back to pad synth. Something about that. So if you really want to do this, probably spend more time getting the right sound, but it should be okay. So the thing is also we want to save this. So we go to music project, surround it. So this is Muse, this is the Ardour, and the just put it here. and we name it surrounded strings dot xz and save it. And then we do the same thing. So select it, set the point range. I have it enabled, record. Okay, so finished it with already also some MIDI ghost notes again. Anyway, so I changed this from input, save it, and let's listen. Sounds already quite nice. Okay, so for what we have left is the electro piano, the mellow pad, and the lead. And I will do this in one go. I already created the three audio tracks to print them. And to just will go quickly, since it should now be clear what you have to do. And so I assigned them to different parts on Yoshimi. You have to switch to a new part and then enable them. Then you can select the sounds. And so we have the E piano. I chose the Sol piano from the let's see, it was the bank of the synth piano, and here is the Sol piano. It's on MIDI channel 3, which is mapped to this channel. This channel is the mellow pad, it's a part 4, MIDI channel 4, and this is the strings pad 2, so it's on the strings pad 2, this one. And on part 5, on MIDI channel 5, this is the lead. I have just a, it's on the synth, and not on the synth, on the strings, and it's Sol 1. So let's see. And one thing, what this 3, 4, and 5 I put not to main output but to part, because Yoshimi has for each channel it has 16 outputs, so it's for each channel it has a stereo output, and if you put that here on the panel to part, then it will output here, and so you have different outputs for each part. And in this case, okay. So in this case, we have part 3 is output 3 of Yoshimi, which is mapped to the electro piano. Part 4 is mapped to the mellow pad, and part 5 is mapped to the lead in, which should be okay. So let's have a look. This is the electric piano. Thank you. Okay, so now I will print them, and here, as you have already seen that, I will just skip this in the video. Okay, so printing is finished. I have put the MIDI tracks up here and disabled them. And and I've created a group here for the background synthesizers, which are the strings, the electropiano and the melopad. And because one thing I forgot, and which I normally do, is if I have the group, I set the color. So let's make the drum something like that. Let them, it's okay. The bass gets and delete. Whatever. Yeah, and the piano. Now we can let it like this. Okay, and then I did some volume balancing here, so put the synths down quite a bit, and so now we have it. A little bit more of them. Okay, save it, and then we are ready for guitar recording.